Located an hour's drive east of Perth, Northam is the centre for wheat growing and sheep raising. It has a population of 7,000 people and is located in the Avon Valley of the Avon River. By 1836, the first farmers had reached the area, and by the 1860s and 70s, expansion of farming in the northern area was rapid, as illustrated by regular reports in the West Australian. By this date, there was even a manufacturing industry in Northam. The Mulby homestead, established in 1836, exists today as a prime example of an early settler's cottage. It's also the center of the Northam Historical Society and has a great display of historical photographs, such as this one illustrating the building out back. There are many old and historical buildings in Northam as reflecting the age of this community. During the 1800s, there was four flour mills servicing the farmers in the northern area. There is still a flour mill operating today, a Western milling. In response to the gold rush, the arrival of the railway in Northam in the early 1890s guaranteed the prosperity of this small Wheatbelt town. The growth of the town is illustrated by its number of churches, first one begun by the 1860s, and by a large number of prosperous public buildings, particularly with the gold rush traffic after the 1890s. There was a large number of taverns and hotels in Northam, outweighing the number of churches. There was only one temperance hotel, which failed to serve any alcoholic beverages. The decline of steam and the arrival of diesel locomotives came to Northam during the 1960s, and by 1965 the old Northam station had been closed and its track located outside the town. At that time, the narrow gauge railway was replaced by the wider standard gauge. This track is used frequently today, with numerous trains passing through the northern area loaded with wheat. Northam today is filled with historic buildings, many of them built for public service during the early 1900s and surviving into use today. Throughout Northam's history, Northam has been the center of recreational pursuits, many centered on the Avon River. These continue today, particularly with the Avon descent trip down the Avon River during its flood period in July, held annually. Many of the old settlers' houses around Northam still make attractive viewing. Recreational activities on the Avon River is a central part of life in Northam. Swans, introduced from England, are a central feature of life, attracting tourists. Early farming in Northam was a major event. A single man pushed a plow rather than using a horse. This feature of plowing was rapidly replaced by horse-drawn plows, which it's made life a lot easier for the farmer. Before long, one horse was replaced by two, and then by four, particularly the powerful Clydesdale models. It's made farming a lot easier. The central pool in Northam attracted life. It was saline free in the early days, although it's highly salty today. Farmers rapidly adopted mechanization, which became more and more complex and effective as time went on. By the 1920s, the horse was beginning to be replaced by plows, which did not require feeding or care. Wheat continued to be gathered and sacked in burlap bags for shipment by the railway to the flour mills. It wasn't until the late 1930s and 40s that bulk handling began to be introduced. War years, particularly between 1914 and 18 and 1939 to 1945, raised the price of wheat, making it more and more attractive for farmers to produce. Raising sheep for the mutton and lamb, and also for the wool, was a profitable activity for Northam farmers, both in the past and in the present. Today, the remnants of old farm machinery can be found throughout Northam. In the present, modern wheat farming is a large-scale, mechanized, and capital-intensive industry, which has assumed central importance to the economy. This is reflected in the many shops and service activities that are operated out of Northam. From tractors through to wheat planting and harvesters, all require regular service and maintenance and replacement. During the November and December harvest season, North is alive with the sound of harvesters and heavy-duty wheat trucks delivering wheat to the wheat bins located on the Transcontinental Railway. Since the 1860s, recreational activities have been a central part of Northern life. In 1876, this article refers to a cricket match between New York. Today, there's many recreational activities in Northam. Many of them focus around the aerial pursuits, including hot air ballooning, hang gliding, and learning to... With an excellent landing strip in Northam, there's a very active flying club. Yet when all is said and done, harvesting the wheat is still of primary importance to the economy in Northam. Drought, locusts, hail, and frost can spell a bad season and an economic downturn for the small Wheatbelt town located in the Avon Valley, 70 kilometers or an hour's drive east of the city of Perth. With the growing world population and an increasing price for wheat, the future of Northam seems to be guaranteed. Although recreational activities are a fun part of Northam, the central business is the farming of wheat, which continues on into the present. I do appreciate your company on this visit to the historic town of Northam, its past, settlement, and present, including its recreational activities. I do hope you have a pleasant day.